Duger, how he was pertinently called in public, goes everywhere with his two bodyguards, who called number one and number two. He owned bar in the city center, and his barman as well. For example, this friendly looking boy with face of China Angel who didn't know what ways needed to get out of debt. His choice was knife. Yeah, so that was the fate of every debtor, motherfucker. Like this one, who sold his life for green means of payment. And the killer. He chooses girls very carefully. Which then he devoutly tended with care. Just that lady had the bad luck that she interlaced love with business. As you see, debtors and loves didn't have so much different fates. So this is criminal stereotype of life. But one day the next debtor appeared. The player. Young man without future. Without ambitions, expelled from school, vacuum cleaner of state money, unfit for manually job, not very intelligent, and parched sex. One fateful day he discovered the favorite addiction of alcoholics, gamblers, and other strange people, a gaming machine. His new passion for games is deadly quick, unstoppable, exciting. Social support and money from his uncommitted parents was given to him possibility to enjoy the pleasure at full speed. Unlike a major part of players, he was AFK. All he gonna do, support or stay was away. Uncommitted parents said no, he hasn't got any more possibilities. Only hope was our usual. send it to him with sweet caring charge, 150%. But he also said, if player doesn't repay the rate, he will be the dead man. The player was like this, might seem the first new machine were flying in his face. So close to dream. But the disaster has come. Every frozen shit, every fucking open up. It was the end of his life. But now, uncommitted parents said, of course, fuck you, sweetheart. And for that all, he forgot to go to the registry office and they canceled his social support. What he gonna do now? Only one he knew in the city was the usurer's barman. The barman's world was drugs. Drugs weren't the only thing in his life. He had two more big activities. The first was his job, like the barman in the usurer's bar in the city center, and accounting. Absence of drugs in combination with usurer's amateur accounting. Suspicion. Big suspicion of stolen alcohol from bar. And again, accounting. Questions with suspicion, and finally, reward. $20 and sometimes little term. So, the job with suspicious user is one thing. The other one was the barman's girlfriend. Punk chick with same hobbies like him, drugs and sex. Very lovely couple. This is the world and life of barman who couldn't leave ugly job because the usurer was unpleasant employer. So, our player came to our barman and asked him for some help. Barman knew about that fucking usurer and told him his miserable story. They agreed that the mustache man must be killed, and they did agree. Unfortunately, barman's girlfriend didn't understand the beauty of that plan. First step was to get some guns, and there was one perfect person for us, the gunman. Barman said they needed two or three guns, but the dealer was careful, and he was hiding himself for selling air guns. That was very unconvincing. Barman offered some cash from selling his own drugs, and the dealer showed his stuff. Knives, guns, pistols, and something like that. After some minutes of negotiation, persuasion, and fights about money, they get some guns. After that, the player called to the usurer and arranged with a meeting in the middle of the old quarry. And he also said that he would pay every money. The usurer was surprised. And of course, very, very suspicious.